Welcome back to Media7's SPADA conference special. We are regularly reminded that TV as we know it is seized by change, that we're headed for a future of convergence where the old assumptions won't apply. Well, allow me to welcome two people whose job it is to live somewhat in that future. The general manager of the Freeview digital platform, Sam Irvin, and a producer already making joined up future TV, 60 Foot Productions Emmy Award winning Marcus Gillezeau. Well, you both.
Thank you.
Now, Sam, anyone who's bought a TV lately will know that it's not your dad's TV anymore. You know, your TV will have a USB port, it'll have a network port in the back, it'll probably have internet apps on it. It's a very different machine. When does that start to change the structure of the broadcasting industry?
Yeah, I think when the number of households with those devices gets to a level where it's economic to roll out those applications. But it's happening very quickly. I mean, they say by the end of 2013, 90% of the traffic on the internet will be video. 200,000 panels that will be sold next year will be connected TVs, so they'll have access to the internet or content delivered over the internet. Manufacturers are talking to us about building Android into their sets, so we'll see those rolling out. So it is going to be very much, I think, what we see, Freeview is an open access platform. We will see the Freeview with Extras model. So that'll be linear TV added to with content that's delivered to your lounge over the internet.
So you're already very much thinking in those terms. Freeview has a play here for this world.
Absolutely. There's some technology called the MHEG interaction channel that's successfully been rolled out in the UK. The BBC use it to deliver the iPlayer direct to people's televisions, and Freesat use it as well. So Freesat and Freeview over there. So yeah, what it's looking for, I guess, is a single standard. So instead of each manufacturer's individual standard, one that's across the industry, which is the way linear broadcasting works very successfully now.
How important is ultra-fast broadband, the big rollout, going to be to you?
Extremely important, because what that will make it is obviously that the quality of that delivery of the content will be much better, and the costs will come down. So at the moment, that's one of the barriers, I think to this in New Zealand, is the cost of delivering that amount of data into the home. Because when you're talking about a large set as against a small PC, you need a lot more data.
Marcus, officially speaking, Storm Surfers, your flagship program, isn't a program, it's a brand. Can you explain that?
Well, Storm Surfers, which is about Ross Clark Jones, Tom Carroll chasing giant waves around the world, which is kind of a lot of fun, we see as an entertainment brand, and we're entertainers. And one of the most important things there is we have a very direct relationship with our audience. And I guess in many ways, in asking about the future, I guess we see ourselves as already been in that future, because our fan base and our audience out there are consuming Storm Surfers across mobile devices. Next year there'll be 20 million 3D mobile devices in the USA, so we'll be delivering to that through games, through e-magazines, interactive e-magazines. But also, we have to assume that our audience is at home, they're watching television, they might be watching another show, and at the same time they're sitting on their mobile device soaking up Storm Surfers, which they've been recommended on Facebook.
Yeah, and I think the Ofcom survey in Britain absolutely showed this is what people are doing. Media consumption is going up because people are sitting there consuming one thing on the phone and watching TV at the same time.
Absolutely, and I mean, my mum's in her 70s, she's your classic public service television viewer, and she's now sitting there on her iPad doing emails and also connecting to people on Facebook. That is the reality of now. But I think what's amazing about the future is that all devices will be internet ready and internet connected and wirelessly connected. So, any kind of show that we create, any entertainment we create, is effectively being delivered across that global network. And there are 750 million people on Facebook and about 500 million video views a day on YouTube. That is the reality of the landscape now, so the future will be even more exciting and more
so
fun.
So actually, perhaps we should have a look at what you're doing so people actually know what we're talking
about
here. Let's have a look at Storm Surfers. Marcus, that looks very exciting, and I think what you're doing works for factual programs like yours.
Does it work for any other genre of television?
Oh, absolutely. We did a show called Scorch, for which we won the International Digital Emmy Award. That was a drama delivered across mobile online, with the finale being a telemovie. And that was hugely successful. We ended up with millions of views online of the videos. Absolutely, it led to an increase in ratings. And I think that's one of the critical things, is that the traditional platforms of television and you know, theatrical release of programs are always going to have a place and still be, in my view, the sort of major property. And what we're doing is wrapping around that the story so people can, you know, consume it on the bus on their way to work.
Now, Sam, whilst we're talking about brave new worlds and new kinds of TV content, at the same time, I think people are concerned about what happens when we do make that shift to broadband and content becomes an issue and certain companies have all the content tied up. Are we going to be able to resolve that?
I would certainly hope so. We've resolved it within, I guess, the telecommunications environment where there were similar issues. So around what we're talking about is distribution. So if someone controls the access to that content through the distribution point, then you do have a problem, because what you get then is you don't have any consumer choice and you get a lack of innovation, and you might get some price gouging as well, although you know, you would hope that wouldn't happen. So yeah, I think it's a necessity. So it will happen. It's just a matter of perhaps time.
Well, this is the interesting question to people, which we touched on in the interview with the Minister. Does all this happen under the auspices of the Broadcasting Act or the Telecommunications Act? Is that clear with anyone yet?
Well, there would be some people who would say you should merge those two, and certainly other jurisdictions have done that, notably Australia and the UK. So maybe that is a model. Certainly at the moment, on one side you have a blank sheet of paper, on the other side you have a small novel. So, you know, something needs to change, I think.
Marcus, you're across all these platforms. Where does your talent come from? Is it kids who've grown up with the internet, or is it people who are broadcast trained?
Oh, the talent to create this kind of content. Look, my daughter's 8. She started cutting shows at 6 on a laptop. That's just totally normal. Every single consumer out there assumes that they are now able to participate and able to be a filmmaker. They don't see any barrier whatsoever. You know, you can get an iPhone and you can shoot something, edit it, and upload it on the internet. And this the other day, I was shown a 3D smartphone where you can shoot, cut, and deliver 3D and put it up on the internet within about 5 minutes. So one has to assume that the consumer out there is also the content creator. And part of that is also the fun of then pulling that content in and making it available. But it has to be editorialized, otherwise there's just too much of it out there. And also, I think, let's just come back to the lounge room. No one's going to sit there and watch Dad surfing the internet on their television for an hour whilst they're looking for their favourite clip. I think there's always going to be a place for scheduled television destination shows. It's just that when that destination show is on air, you know, Mum might be watching the 3D you know, cooking show that just got created by someone in Alabama.
And I think when consumers become creators, perhaps that's when things really change. Thank you, gentlemen. And that's our show. Thanks to Sam Irvin and Marcus Gillezeau. And thanks again to Michael Steadman, Jonathan Coleman, Peter Thompson, Ian Taylor and David Beetson. I'm Russell Brown. This is Media7, and goodbye.